All right, guys, welcome back. This is episode 24 of our Madden 25 Connected Franchise Player Mode Johnny Manziel Cleveland Browns series. I'm recording this straight after going through the whole offseason. And I gotta say, Browns management letting us down a little bit, unfortunately. We are, of course, picking up this second season. We were eliminated last season, the episode yesterday. I'm speaking in terms of last season, but the episode was, in fact, just yesterday's. We lost, of course, as we all saw, in the AFC Championship game to the New England Patriots. The Patriots went on to destroy the Vikings in the Super Bowl by a score of 23-6. So we take some solace in that, knowing that the team that we lost to in the AFC Championship game actually did go on to win a championship. That takes some of the sting out. Still, some of it is still there, of course, though. This, of course, is our next regular season, season 2014. Obviously, the 2013 season was our first season because of the way the rookies were implemented into Madden 25. So this is season number two, and we have some updates to provide you guys with. I'll go ahead here. Let's go to the roster. I did have the option, which was weird to me. I did not have any prompts all season to scout. Obviously, Johnny Manziel would not be in charge of scouting for the Browns, but I did have the option in Madden 25 for whatever reason to do the draft myself. I simulated the whole thing, and it was an interesting experience to say the least. We're gonna go position by position. Pardon me. Very quickly, just to give you guys a chance to take a look at the new roster. The Browns drafted 17 players. They traded away their first-round pick, picking up an extra first-rounder for next year, and selected six times in the fourth round. They had six picks in the last two rounds, and I guess just looking for some diamonds in the rough. There's no changes to our quarterbacking crew, same four players. Halfback, unfortunately, Deion Lewis left. He signed in Tampa Bay. 4 years, $6.5 million for him. The good news is that Tate is still around, as is Terrence West. Baleen Cole was a draft pick for us. Fourth round, 15th overall. He is not good. just really lacking the skills and abilities. Hopefully, we won't have to play him at all. Marcel Reese comes to us in free agency. Probably my favorite free agent pickup. He's signed for 4 years, $14 million. He's going to be such a great addition to our offensive attack. He's going to get carries. He's going to get receptions. It'll be great. Hilliard, last year's starting fullback, is currently a free agent. Chris Presley, for whatever reason, still here. Don't know what to do with him. Don't know why he's here. Don't know why my management likes him, but he's here. Wide receivers look quite a bit different. Gordon is, of course, still here. He's in the last year of his deal. Hopefully, he signs an extension this year, stays long-term. Benet Burleson retired. Santonio Holmes signed in Oakland. 1 year, $5.4 million for him. I guess management just not willing to pony up that kind of cash. And so Gordon Hawkins and Benjamin going to be our feature receivers this year. Faison and Bueno are rookies. Though they both have good size, I'm very skeptical as to how well they're going to be able to play. They both have decent hands starting off for rookies. Route running ability, again, pretty good for rookies. But the physicals, just, you know, I question them. Faison, for a big man 6'4", these are workable. He can play. But Bueno, with the terrible jumping rating, horrible agility, I really question how much success he can have. But we'll see. They're both just 20 years old, so hopefully Faison can really develop. But I'm skeptical about Bueno. For the record, too, Bueno was a fourth-round pick. Faison was a third-rounder. So both those guys, relatively high picks. Tight ends, obviously Cameron sticks around, signing a large extension last year. Kyle Rudolph comes to us on a deal that'll pay him $4.68 million over three seasons. Great deal as far as I'm concerned, though. The thing that confused me, Barnage and Grimble still here as well. The thing that confused me, Jermaine Gresham signed in Cincinnati for 1 year, $760,000. That's just $760,000 over 1 year. The guy who we got from the Bengals last year, goes back to them in free agency. Don't know why our management wouldn't pony that up. Grimble, who's a second-year guy, signed with us $940,000. So we're actually paying him more, and he's useless. Bad decision, but I'm confident that Kyle Rudolph will be able to play. On the offensive line, not a whole lot of change across the board. And what there is, I wasn't super psyched about, to be perfectly honest. Berentine was a sixth-round pick for us. He's terrible, 75 strength, not doing anything. But Joe Thomas is still stellar. Tannen Bobblitz was our top pick this year, 30th overall in the second round. He is also useless. He's injured right now. He'll miss the first 4 weeks of the season. His speed is great. His acceleration isn't really good enough, though. His impact blocking is great, but his strength is 77. You cannot play on the offensive line with 77 strength. So disappointing there. Chilo Raquel comes to us in free agency. He signed 4 years, $5 million. Hopefully he can develop into a starter. Center Alex Mack was franchise tagged. Christian Yount, still there. He was with us last year, still there. No change at the center position. Right guard, Uche Nwaneri, who people remember from our JAG series, comes to us in free agency. 1 year, $3 million. So second year we take a flyer just on a one-year deal for a veteran right guard. Last year it was Davin Johnson. This year it is Uche Nwaneri. Hopefully that works out. Anthony Steen also comes to us in free agency. He signs 3 years, $2.4 million. Solid depth signing. Not really a starter, but solid depth. Hopefully Nwaneri, who's a real bruiser, can't move at all, but a big mauler for sure, can provide us with some run blocking. And then Mitchell Schwartz developed very nicely last year, now 89 overall, the right tackle spot. John David Harvin comes to us at the tackle spot. He was drafted in the seventh round this year. He, like every other offensive lineman we drafted, is useless. 69 strength, 56 speed. That's trash. And the reason that Mitchell Bettino is not here is because he was actually traded. Bettino was traded to the Redskins for a fourth and sixth round pick in this past draft, which is a shame because we really squandered those picks. Jarrell Casey was the big offseason signing for this team. Actually, surprisingly, Browns, given that they had the number one ranked defense this past year, they invested a lot of money on the defensive side of the ball, really cheaped out on the offensive side of the ball, which is bad news for us. Casey got 5 years, $55.7 million, more than 10 a season. Craziness, more than 11 a season, hell. Damon Harrison, very solid backup. Kind of makes you wonder why we made that move, but whatever. Harrison signed to a new contract, 1 year, $3.88 million. Right end, Desmond Bryant is an incumbent. Behind him, Jaqueline Provost was a fourth-round selection this year. And looking at his stuff, I fail to see how he can really be successful in the NFL. Not pathetic, but not a great pick. Defensive tackle Dan Williams comes to us in free agency. 5 years, $24 million for him. Eduardo Rivers, rookie, is the backup there. He was selected in the fifth round. As well as Mark Castillo, another draft pick. He was drafted in the fourth round, 30th overall. Both these guys, you know, again, I question the decision. Rivers has excellent speed but no acceleration. Both guys, the block shedding for Rivers is pretty sweet. Castillo is pretty pathetic. But the strength, not good enough, just not good enough. Anyways, we'll see how that goes, how that turns out. Left outside linebacker, A.C. Tate, the backup, is a fourth-round selection for us, selected 22 in that round. His speed, 75, strength, 64, acceleration, 67, not good enough. Fortunately, Paul Kruger is still there to be our starter. Middle linebacker, Carlos Dansby, still around. Yawin Smallwood came to us from the Falcons in exchange for two sixth-round picks. Smallwood, I don't know. We'll see how he turns out. He's got some great physicals, 95 acceleration, 84 speed, could be a great incumbent. Dansby's really slowing down. Lachi Fassian, a rookie, he comes to us as a third-round selection, and unfortunately for a third-round pick, he's, again, pretty useless. Right outside linebacker, Barkevious Mingo, still there. The big move here, Christian Kirksey traded away to the Panthers, so he's no longer with us, but Desmond Moses was signed in free agency. Got my notes all in front of me here. He signed a one-year deal worth $680. Not a bad signing for a depth guy. Corners, Joe Hayden, still around. Fortunately, this is a big plus to our team. Justin Gilbert, of course, still around. Aside from that, Leon McFadden, still around. He was with us last year. Brandon Hughes, another incumbent. And Doral Carrington, the only newcomer. He was a late pick, and he is pretty useless. Yeah, not really usable at all. But fortunately, we have four guys ahead of him who can play. Isaiah Trufant was released, and Pierre Desir was traded away as well over the course of the offseason. Tashawn Gibson, Craig Bielo, our free safeties. Bielo, a sixth-round pick this year. backing up Gibson, who just signed a huge contract last year. He doesn't really have the physicals required to play in the NFL. And same thing here, Kerry Todd, who's a fourth-round pick for us, will be behind Dante Whitner and is pretty useless. Here's another signing I really like. Justin Tucker signed on to be our new kicker. Billy Cundiff retired, and so Cundiff comes in, which is excellent. And unfortunately, I regret to inform everybody that Zoltan Mesko will be the punter of the Cleveland Browns for the next 2 years. He signs for $1.4 million. Fortunately, we're not paying him much, but unfortunately, he's terrible. Can't really get the job done. Just can't do it. Picks, as you can see, we got two first-rounders for next year. So we have stocked up on some picks, which is great. However, I just hope we don't squander them. We really don't have much to show for our draft this year. Browns management letting us down. But hopefully we're able to turn things around nonetheless. That one injury to our new left guard, our top pick from this year, that is Tannen Bobolith, is the only thing that's really necessary to update you guys for the injuries. Nothing else there. Also, the Raiders are moving to San Antonio. That's a thing. I don't think there's anything else to report in terms of, there you go, what's in a name? Fans irritated by the fact that the owner ignored the voting results. I don't know what they're calling the team. I'll update you guys on that. But they're not going to stay the Raiders. They're going to change it to something else and pick modern jerseys. So it'll be interesting to see how that turns out. Anyways, the only thing left to do, really, before tomorrow's game against the Texans, ironically a team that we traded with this offseason, is to upgrade Johnny Manziel. He's got 25,000 points rolled over from last season in terms of, and also all of the preseason games. I simulated all the preseason games, but I did all the practices, so we got our points from that. First thing we do is get him up to 91 throwing power. As you can see, his overall number has dipped a bit from last season. That's very normal in Madden, of course, for anybody who's a veteran Maddener. Medium accuracy will get it up to a 90. Aside from that, let's go ahead, let's get his overall throw accuracy up to 91. And there we go. It becomes very easy to spend large amounts of points as Madden goes on with different players. Upgrades are expensive, but we get him there, and he will start the season at an 88 overall, much better than last season. But we'll see. So anyways, thank you so much for joining me for this off-season recap video. All in all, I'd say I'm very disappointed with the moves that were made by the Browns management without any say on our part. However, with that being said, I am optimistic that we will have another successful season. I think there are enough tools for us to be successful. And hopefully, this upcoming season, the 2014 campaign, we will advance to the Super Bowl and win it all. Last season, 15-1, very successful regular season, but it tailed off with a disappointing finish in the playoffs. This year, we got nothing else to play for, just a Super Bowl. Let's get her done, folks. I'll join you. Join me tomorrow. Happy Friday. Episode number one of the new season of the Cleveland Browns Johnny Football series. I'm thinking that I will actually name it season two instead of going on to episode 25. Just have a 24 episode first season. Second season gets underway. So anyways, thank you again for joining me. Watch for that tomorrow and happy Friday. And until then, I'm Tuxedo T-Shirt and I'm out.